Hello everybody and welcome back to the channel. Today I want to show you how I use the Walleye and all the older systems of the F-18 Hornet and still be pretty effective. This is pretty much a no teapot attack tutorial that only is using the ground mapping radar and the Walleye bomb. You enjoy. So, first of all, because I actually haven't set any proper waypoints to my target, which is this AN-30 on the ramp, I'm going to measure out where I have to fly the 43 degree course. I then set this up here, and yeah, I said it's vintage. When I mean vintage, this indeed is pretty. It's pretty much using all of the vintage systems of the Hornet. I'm loaded up with two Walleyes, the data link port, and a little bit of extra fuel. And then air-to-air missiles. But I'm not going to encounter any air-to-air threats, it's just I carry them for completion of the loadout. So let's go into the air-to-ground mode. And target is around 50 miles away, so I have to go onto the next largest view option. Now, a lot of people do struggle in using air-to-ground radars, and I totally understand why. It's like weird blobs that don't really mean anything. Yeah, but you can actually help it by overlaying or by looking at the map in the same size, then you can see some things. For example, this ridge line here and this one here, it's pretty much this area here. This ridge line is this here. Everything behind that is black, so the ground mapping radar actually can't see what's behind those hills. Black areas are either water or hills that the ground mapping radar can't look behind. Now, when I look, Kutazi is right in front of me. At this river, I first want to see if I can actually find the river. And indeed, when I look here, this looks like it could be the river. So let's make the test. And oh yeah, here, this black line is the river. Let's go down in the scale a little. This is actually not my waypoint of the attack zone. I place it at a much different spot. Miles. Wait, no, that this is the point I place. And I'm actually pretty close already. My target is this little airfield here, so I can try and pretty much go into the EXP mode. I know that I have to go a little bit to the left. So let's see. I have to go a little further up and left. I'm already pretty close. I can go to the EXP2. And yep, and that's there. That should be the airfield. And when I go now into EXP3, and yeah, I found the airfield. And better yet, This is my target. This bright spot here is the plane that I have to bomb. Here's the runway, the taxiways, it's all there. And all I used is the ground mapping radar. Now, let me set up the weapon. Walleye, Data Link 13. It defaults to the walleye that's on this wing. So I select that one. I'm in range and I'm caged. I'm armed and now I pretty much just turn off heading select. Turn my airplane. Towards the target. Uncage the seeker. Release the bomb. And now I pretty much just need to guide the bomb in. Wait a second. Here's the airplane. So, yeah, it's can be a little finicky. And impact. Target destroyed. With relative ease. By just using the ground mapping grader and the wall. I obviously know the plane doesn't really like to fly with one wing so heavy. So let's look a other target out. Let's say, I don't know. Let's say we want to bomb a hangar on, or let's bomb one of those two helicopters here on Batumi. Oh no, this large building here. So again, point out the course. It is 219 degrees. We're gonna set that up. Plane is shaking. Why is it shaking? Oh yeah, okay. No. Give a little bit more power, I'm slowing down way too much. Oh boy. Hey, that's a bomb. I don't actually have a head tracking right now. So I do kind of need all those autopilot functions. What did I say? 219. Let's do 220. Okay. Also, let's select the next walleye. Just double click on here. Weapon. Bam. Next walleye selected. That one is ready to go. And let's accelerate the timer a little. So let's halt. Okay. Wow, Wow. Wow, 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 wow. Just afterburner the whole time. So, now, Batumi has a really interesting topography. You can easily see this wide curve here. This is going to be a point of interest for the ground mapping radar. We will be easily able to see this harbor area. Let me just draw a line that is a little longer to find the airfield. And, as I said, we have here this curve. We also can see the river right about here. And the airfield is going to be around here. To get a better view, let's use the EXP1 mode. Oh wait, the airfield actually is in front of the river. No problem. Okay, let's go a little bit more in depth. And, yep, here's the airfield. Select it, maybe even go EXP3 to get a much more zoomed in image, and we are looking at the end of the runway, it seems. Yeah, here's like the parking area, and I think that's the building that's interesting to us. When we look up here, this is the one big black spot, and this is the one that is interesting us. So that's the one we want to hit. And when we get a little closer, the detail gets better and better. I go from the afterburner. And yeah, that's our target. We can now also. Right, should also be able to. See, I pretty much pointed the wall, the pointer perfectly where I want to have the bomb. Now let's tell the walleye to uncage its seeker. We are in range. Also, by the way, another really nice trick for the walleye. Use a black-white screen on the center line. And, yeah, we are in range. Bombs away! Now we need to correct it a little up. And we want to aim for. Oh, where is it? It's a little hard to see sometimes. So those are the tanks. It's that one. Also change the gain a little. Yeah, and we are pretty much perfectly pointing at the building with that we want to take out. With this technique, you really don't need to have any targeting pods, or you also don't need to punch in accurate coordinates. You pretty much just need to use the ground radar, find the point of interest, get in range for the walleye, or even the slam. Walleye and slam are very similar, and boom, target destroyed. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Overall, the procedure to deliver wall eyes using just the ground mapping radar and the data link port is pretty simple. And you can be incredibly accurate, even though there's like SAM sites up and the wall eye, when you drop it from the proper altitudes, has a max range of about 20 nautical miles, so you can even do quite a bit of standoff. And when you do night attacks or you need more standoff, just use the SLAM, which is very similar. It can also glide in on a point that you selected using the ground radar. And yeah, it is really useful to learn how to properly read the ground mapping radar to know what each spot means. For example, dark spots are where there's no return of radar radiation. That's either water or hills. So here's like hillsides. When we look at the map, we should have see here several hillsides that kind of look like this. And bright areas are generally speaking, okay, now there's no buildings down here, but if I would turn around, you would see that bright areas are either ones that point right at us, like for example the wall of a hill or a mountain, or they are very sharp built structures. So, like cities, for example. Now, when you just look at the ground mapping radar again, you see here's the river, again, a dark area. And here, all these bright areas, that's the city. And with that knowledge, you can be pretty sure where you are, what you're aiming at. You then simply, right, I need to select. Yeah, you can simply then point your marker at where you want to drop your bombs, for example, on the harbor. And then you can go ahead and select the EXP modes to get a better view, a zoomed in view with a lot more detail of the area, to then deliver your bombs, for example, on these oil tanks right here. You can then also see where larger single buildings are, for example, here, this industrial complex with some factories. You can also see where there's a rail station. Oh, now we are too far to the side. But yeah, when you actually look, zoom in, down there's a rail station. Then we have here the industrial area that I pointed out. Here's the oil tanks. And you can read all this by just using the ground mapping radar and with having a little bit of experience on those systems. I hope you could learn a little bit with my video, and I hope you consider subscribing to the channel to get more of these relatively simple to use tricks for different airplanes in DCS to be more effective. Fly safe, and we see us in the next one. Bye-bye.